All right, everyone knows that you can go to the Caribbean, Hawaii, the South Pacific, and have a great expensive dive trip with clear water, colorful fish, but what about here in New Jersey? Can the most densely populated state with a long history of pollution have anything to see in its waterways? Yes, in many ways, New Jersey may have a more challenging dive environment, but in many ways, it's also more rewarding. In my 30 years of diving, some of the best dives I've ever had have been right here in my home state, just a short ride down the turnpike. Here are 10 amazing examples of the marine life you could see diving in New Jersey. And by the way, if you like this video and would like to see a second one with 10 more examples, please let us know in the comments. Let's dive in. You can see blennies on almost every shore dive. Unlike most fish that shy away from divers, the feather blenny comes out to greet you like a faithful pet. The blenny is just happy to see you, like you are when the pizza guy shows up. It loves living in rocks and also between the mussel beds, but it's well adapted to all the crap that people throw into the water. PVC pipes are a favorite, but you could also see blennies in broken bottles, cinder blocks, Bud Light cans, even a car battery after all the acid leaches out into the water. If you offer a little treat, the blenny will eat right out of your hand. This is one of my favorite fish to see when diving, but it's not a fish you can see on every dive. The striped burrfish has a unique spiny appearance, and of course, it can puff itself up to protect itself from predators. It thrives in our coastal waters by feeding on shrimp and mussels. By the way, this fish has a very close Caribbean cousin called the webbed burrfish that looks very similar. You can tell that this butterfly fish is out of place, and that's because he's not a true New Jersey resident. They're native to tropical waters but get swept up in warm ocean currents every summer. From August through November, you can reliably see them on almost every dive. Other tropical fish get swept up as well, but what makes the butterfly unique is its ability to find shelter, food, and evade predators throughout the season, allowing them to thrive until the water gets cold. You won't see the shark relative on every dive, but the clearnose skate is a graceful swimmer that can be seen cruising along the seafloor. It's more active at night, but you can see them anytime while it searches for its favorite food consisting of shrimp, crabs, or small fish. It gets its name because of an almost clear translucent patch that forms its snout. The spiny dogfish is a small shark that reaches about 3 feet in length. While they can occasionally be spotted at popular inshore dive sites, they're more common out in the ocean. Despite their size, these sharks are skilled predators, using sharp teeth and remarkable agility to hunt fish and invertebrates. They have a potential lifespan of up to 100 years, but overfishing has significantly reduced their population. During the day, you may only catch a glimpse of an American eel poking its head out from the rocks, but they're surprisingly common wherever there are sufficient hiding spots. These nocturnal hunters come alive at night, slipping out of their hiding spot to cruise along the ocean floor in full predator mode, feasting on crustaceans, worms, mollusks, and small fish. What's fascinating is their incredible migration, traveling thousands of miles to spawn in the Sargasso Sea. The plainhead filefish is not a very common occurrence. Its presence probably depends on ocean currents, but we are well within its range, which goes from Canada all the way down to South America. During the past 5 years, it's only been around during last year when it was a fairly common sighting during the summer months in Point Pleasant. Lion seahorses aren't rare, but they're not easy to find either. They're masters of disguise, changing color to blend in with seagrass and underwater plants. What's surprising to me is how I've been able to find more seahorses this year while diving in New Jersey than I have in almost 30 years of diving in the Caribbean. Despite this, lion seahorses are still threatened by habitat loss, pollution, and overfishing, making every sighting special. Besides the tank at ShopRite or your favorite seafood restaurant, you could find lobsters at almost every dive site. They are more common during certain times of the year, and in New Jersey, you can catch 6 of them each day as long as they meet regulations and are not females with eggs. They may be crawling around at night, but usually during the day, they're at the bottom in the deepest, darkest holes that they can find shelter in. The angelfish is arguably the most beautiful fish to grace the waters of New Jersey. Like the butterfly fish, it gets carried up in the warm Gulf Stream currents and ends up in New Jersey during the late summer. Somehow, it manages to avoid predators and thrive in these waters until the fall. Unfortunately, the angelfish isn't able to migrate back to warmer waters and faces challenges as the temperatures drop. There's a lot more to see in New Jersey than these 10 creatures that I showed you here today. If you're already a diver, I hope this inspires you to give New Jersey diving a try. And if you're not a diver, I hope this inspires you to learn. If you like this video, let us know in the comments, and we'll be sure to come out with a new video with 10 more exciting creatures that we could find while diving in New Jersey.